This is a production of PBS 39.
Have you ever wanted to retreat from your hectic life? Find a way to just slow down and enjoy things more? Well, Alice Massimi introduces us to a couple from Illinois who escaped the rat race by relocating to Berks County.
Meet the Lands. Donna's a cookbook author and food consultant. Her husband, Ed, spent more than 20 years as a videotape editor at the ABC affiliate in Chicago.
Run and gun, beat the clock, deadlines, two or three a day.
That was the case until fate threw them in another direction.
Ed has a brother that lived in Bechtelsville, which is about 8 miles away, and we were actually on a driving vacation to go and visit him. And so on the way here, we were having the big talk about what do we really need from life, and we can't stay with a job that's not fun anymore.
During that visit, the Lambs happened upon this Berks County building in the peaceful village of Huff's Church, about 30 miles southwest of Allentown.
We found this building and said it shouldn't be sitting vacant, and we needed something different to do for the next leg of our lives, and so we thought we would do something fun here with this building and renovate it and fix it up and save it because we love the bones that we saw here.
In 1997, Ed and Donna Land bought this building and named it Land Haven. They spent a year and a half to turn it into a bed and breakfast, an antique store, and a musical venue.
It needed a great deal of work. The front porch was in bad shape. We rebuilt the front porch. The back porch was falling off to the point Donna wouldn't come up and in off across the back porch. There were leaks in the roof.
But that didn't deter the Lands. They'd promised themselves they'd restore the cornerstone of the community, the general store.
Well, it was the post office. It worked a little bit like the bank. It was the social gathering. At Saturday night, they played Hasenfuss, I think it is. It's a card game, German Pennsylvania.
According to the Lands' research, it all began in 1871 when the first store was built. Soon after, Samuel Bittenbender, an area mine owner, bought the site and put his son-in-law, Samuel Bechtel, in charge of the business.
In 1910, D.R. Bechtel added the bigger general store. We sometimes think he knew how to spend his father-in-law's money, so if you look at the shelving, everything is pretty pristine, pretty nicely done, well decorated, lots of frill.
Bechtel sold the store in 1920 to the Pilgerts for $3,100. Many of the people still living in the area have fond memories of it during that time.
I remember coming in here. I remember they had a big cheese bell. I mean, you know, things jumped out at you.
You had a calendar, and usually the canned goods was in back of the calendar, and the clerk would get it for you with a grapple hook.
Candy, penny candy, and sodas.
And I sent the kids over for a loaf of bread or whatever I needed, and it was very handy. I wish it was still a general store.
In 1986, Diane Selwood bought the building and created a dress shop and store called Duncan Fields.
I think it was very successful for a short period of time. And then it was difficult to maintain the business here, and it fell on hard times.
When the dress shop closed, many locals feared a developer would come in and tear it down. Lucky for them, they got the Lands.
I think it's wonderful just to see, because there aren't many of these buildings left. They're, you know, the old stores, the way they were, and they've really kept it very original.
We retained something that was here for many, many years, and we still have it, because a lot of it is disappearing, and once it's gone, it's gone. It's not going to get it back.
This is the Bechtel room. Bechtel is one of our queen-size rooms. The bathroom has a steam shower sauna.
Today, the Lands have a 5-bedroom bed and breakfast. Open year-round, the rooms are full of antiques and unique decorations.
This is the general store of 1910. It's a little more ornate than the store of 1870.
And while the store is no longer home to a general store, it still houses a variety of merchandise. Some of it the Lands brought from Illinois, and some of it never left.
This is like a bullion. We have galanga root and blue dye.
An antique store, Ed's sister says, is more like a social hall. In addition to having friends over to enjoy Donna's amazing cooking, Land Haven holds concerts on the weekends.
For Planets, it's all about connecting between people, and the people that show up for this are really a nice bunch of people. The room's great acoustically, the whole place feels good, looks great.
I think it's worth saying that the Lands have been just, you know, sort of
wonderful asset to our town and to the area generally. They're great company.
We're feeling like we're at a really, really good place now, and we are doing what we want to do. And that's a really huge thing at this point in our life.
This is wonderful. This is, I when I retired here, I figured I added 10 years to my life.
They're not only adding years to their lives, but they say they're having the time of their lives. For Tempo, I'm Alice Massimi reporting.